Hello, friends, and welcome into NFL Daily. I am your host, Tom Downey, and Hater Tom is back because today we are taking a look at the six most likely round one draft busts. You can dread it, you can run from it, but busts still arrive all the same in the NFL draft. Every player has risk involved. We're taking a look today at some of the prospects who might be a little bit more likely than others to end up busting. We'll start with Justin Herbert, the now Chargers quarterback. He was drafted number 6 overall, and the upside is there, and this is certainly the type of prospect you gamble on if you're a team searching for a franchise quarterback. But he does still need development. And in reality, it's pretty darn unlikely that all three quarterbacks taken inside the top 6 this year are going to end up hitting. Now for me, and we'll talk more about this, came down to Tua or Herbert. And we'll see if Herbert actually starts in year one. I'd give him the keys to the franchise because I want to see what this young kid has. Very intelligent, has the arm that you want, has the athleticism that you want. But there are times where, what are you doing out there? Throws, there are some moments where he just doesn't process as well as you want him to. Now, this past year, the production went up significantly in terms of the completion percentage. But the iffy decision-making was still there. I hated the Oregon offense. It was very much a check-down, screen-heavy offense. It inflated his completion percentage there, but he was better as far as I was concerned this year. So again, I like the idea of gambling on Justin Herbert, but we have to acknowledge the risk involved, given that in reality, he's nowhere near as developed as Tua or Joe Burrow was. So who is more likely to bust? If you are terrified of the injuries, type in your T in the comment section. In the end, I felt that going with Tua because of the injuries was a little bit of a cop-out, so I went with Justin Herbert instead, but you guys cast your votes H or T. Moving on now to A.J. Terrell, the cornerback out of Clemson. I thought he was just overdrafted, plain and simple, for starters. 16th overall goes to the Falcons, who desperately wanted C.J. Henderson. They weren't able to get him, though. My biggest concern with Terrell is, A, he's probably going to be thrown into the fire immediately, which could be good or bad for him. And if he doesn't do a better job of locating the football, I think he's in trouble. And I think you might end up having for Cowboys fans who know this, a Chidobe Awuzie on your hands. Because the ball production wasn't great at Clemson. Now, there were certainly flashes. When he did get a center, he often made interceptions, but a distinct lack of pass breakups. He got roasted by LSU in the national championship game, which is understandable. Ja'Marr Chase and Justin Jefferson are awesome. But he's going to face those caliber of receivers every single week. That is at least a red flag there. I think he might be CB1 immediately in Atlanta, which frankly isn't saying much because Isaiah Oliver, Kendall Sheffield, Jordan Miller, that doesn't really move the needle at all. So because I thought Terrell was overdrafted, I have concerns about him just being good enough to have a super successful career that you expect out of your number 16 overall pick. I think this might be more of a number 2 corner. Now, I still got some players I want to go through, but I want to hear from you guys, too. Who do you think will end up busting out of round one this year? It's going to be more than 6. Probably not going to be every player on this list. I think there will be some successful players here, but there are going to be busts. That's why it's tricky to figure them out, because if people knew they were going to bust, they weren't going to go in round one. But shoot your shot and let me know in the comments section. Austin Jackson is next up here. I like the athlete. I like the upside. I get why he went in round one. He can move. He can be a potential left tackle. But he's raw, guys. He didn't really have that great of a year at USC. He might be pressed into left tackle duties day one in Miami, which sometimes players respond to that, and giving them those reps pays off in the long run. Sometimes they never really fully recover and really get going in the end. I got concerns about just Jackson, the prospect. If he doesn't develop, and the reality is the track record of offensive linemen being developed well in the NFL isn't nearly as good as we want it to be or think it should be, that's a red flag there. Now, Miami has a very high upside line. Is that, maybe that's what I'll call it? How about unproven offensive line? I could see Saul McKinley and or Robert Hunt starting somewhere on the right side of that line. Maybe Julian Davenport holds the job over Jackson. I don't really see how that would benefit Miami in the long run, because Davenport ain't it. So I get the upside with Jackson. I do. I am concerned that upside is never going to be fully realized regardless of what team wins. This is not a shot at the Miami Dolphins, even though, as we'll discuss, fit matters in the NFL a lot more than what we want to admit. Now, it is almost Mother's Day, so I need everyone out there to be the good son or daughter and get your mother something nice, even just something as simple as flowers. If you're living in different states and you can't go home and see her this year, you can send her flowers. Chatsports.com/mom. That link will save you 15% off whatever you want on the site, be it flowers. They got gifts like chocolates as well. Always preferred the flowers, and I just think it's a better gift, but it's up to you guys. It's chatsports.com/mom, and I know it's an easy URL to remember. I'll still put it in the comments and the description to make life easier on you guys. Next up is Kalyvon Chase, and I want to remind everyone, if you watched our live draft coverage, I liked this pick. At the time, I think Chaseon was my best available player. Now, I think he was top 16 on my board, 20th overall. But if we're being honest with the prospect, we have to acknowledge the potential downside here. I am willing to bet on Chaseon, but it is a bet. And there is a real chance that despite having all the traits you want in an edge rusher, the lack of production at LSU continues into the NFL. Maybe he's a bit better than an athlete, but maybe a Jarvis Jones type, which you don't want to have as a mid-ish first-round pick. He was not a sack machine at LSU. Now, I like his fit in Jacksonville. I like the player. I would bet on him. I like the pick from Jacksonville. But the NFL draft really is just betting. There's no such thing as a 100% guaranteed bet to hit. You're going to have risk involved across the board. The upside for Chaseon made it worth it for me, but I am aware that there is some real bust potential there. Now, we still got some round one picks to get to, but let me know in the comments, who was the worst round one pick this year? Maybe it's a guy we'll get to here in a little bit, but let me know what you guys think in the comments section. Another player that I also kind of like the pick, Jalen Reagor, just drafted him in a fantasy dynasty draft. I took him. But we have to be and acknowledge that despite being a great athlete who's dynamic with the ball in his hands, there are some significant red flags for Jalen Reagor. Much like Kalyvon Chaseon, the production this year was bad. Now, I'm going to blame most of that on the fact that TCU's quarterback play was horrible, but I think maybe more so, drop issues are a big-time red flag here. You can be a great athlete, but if I can't get the ball in your hands because you drop out 13% of the passes that come your way, what am I going to do with you? Now, he was great in 2018, back when the quarterback play was at least steady. 72 grabs, 1,000 yards, 9 touchdowns, almost cut in half this past year. Now, the quarterback play for TCU, again, was, I'm just going to call it horrific. It was just not accurate whatsoever. But Reagor didn't play as well. That has to be a concern. If you see a player that was really good in 2018 now become okay in 2019 in terms of production, that is a major, major red flag you have to be aware of. And I'm trying not to pile on too much here, Philadelphia, because I also hated the Jalen Hurts pick. They went heavy at receiver, which I did like, all right, because Alshon Jeffrey's got maybe 1 year left with that team. DeSean Jackson's aging. You're hoping Jalen Reagor, be it on the slot or on the outside, can have a big, big impact on your offense. The Eagles' track record, though, of developing wide receivers is not good. Now, these are just players taken in the past 4 rounds since 2014. J.J. Arcega-Whiteside didn't do anything. He really struggled. I was surprised by that one. Matt Collins has hung around, but he hasn't really done much of anything. Nelson Agholor showed, like, maybe a couple flashes early, but he can't catch. Gator arms everything. He's out now. Jordan Matthews didn't really pan out. Josh Huff was a huge bust. And there are going to be busts at receiver. There were so many guys taken early. There's going to be players who at least don't live up to expectations. So which round one wide receiver is most likely to bust? Let me know what you guys think in the comment section. I went with Jalen Reagor. I think you can make an argument for other players. Again, it was a good pick by Philadelphia, but we have to be aware that there is some potential downside here, especially if the drop issues continue to persist for Reagor. And finally, the one I think we'll mostly agree on, Jordan Love. If you want to go with most likely, I'm not guaranteeing he's going to bust, but most likely, it has to be Jordan Love. Now, I went in order of the draft picks here, but we saved the biggest bust potential for last. There is no bigger boom or bust prospect this year. He took a massive step back in 2019. Now, Green Bay's draft, clearly, despite what the GM says, was all about Jordan Love. The Packers move up to get him, and they're hoping that the 2018 Jordan Love is closer than 2019 Jordan Love. The flashes are there. He's got the arm strength, the smooth release. I get it. I was super intrigued by it exiting 2018. He was one of the first guys I watched after the 2019 draft ended. But he just wasn't good this past year. Like, there's no way around it. Jordan Love struggled amid a brand new coaching staff and losing all of his skill players. That could shatter his confidence. We'll see how the Packers are all in. But there is some massive risk involved here. Maybe he ends up being that great round one prospect who develops and hits for you and you have a franchise quarterback. What I am terrified of is that he's Paxton Lynch. That worries me. So we'll see how it turns out for Jordan Love, but there is no bigger boom or bust prospect this year than Jordan Love.